the Indianapolis Colts. Their win total sits at 9. To go over is plus 110. To go under is minus 140. They are second in the division at plus 140 to win the AFC South. To win the AFC, they are plus 1,400. To make the playoffs, same juice on both sides, minus 115. Projected favorites in 12 games. Now, I don't know that that's been actually updated, knowing what we know about, you know, Nelson being out and having some injury issues and all that. Projected strength of schedule is 12th. That is our 12th easiest based on win total projections. Over under the last four seasons. They went over last year, went under the year before, over, blah, blah, blah. You get the point. Frank Reich consistently puts his teams in position to win games. Everything about this team is good, except for the quarterback room and the wide receiver room, which are fairly important in today's NFL. In 2020, they were the only team in the NFL in the top five on offense and defense EPA gained from turnovers. That's a luck stat. Don't know if that can be consistent or not. Normally there's a regression there, but we shall see. They faced the single easiest schedule in the NFL in 2020, and this year's is not like super hard.
It's
difficult.
It's easier. Yeah. It's harder than last year.
Yeah, it's definitely harder than last year, but it's not unmanageable. We'll say that. I talked about Sam Darnold's QBR on the Carolina Panthers thing from a clean pocket. Carson Wentz, dead last in on-target percentage, 74.9% from a clean pocket. That ain't good. That's saying when you are not being pressured at all, you still can't hit your guys. Like, that's not good. From, you know, the front office to the coaching staff, it makes it difficult for me to go under here because this is such a well-built team other than those positions. But those positions matter, man. Like, I've actually got them right on the 9. I'm going to go under because I don't know what's up with the injury issues. I expected them to beat the Seahawks in week 1. So I'm going to go under here. Like, this is not one that I'm going to bet. I don't feel great about it, but I've got them at 8 wins. Like, I don't feel good about this team.
Wham. With a healthy Carson Wentz, you thought they would beat the Seahawks?
I kind of did. I thought that they'd be able to come out and surprise them a little bit. Like, I don't think Carson Wentz is great, but I especially don't think he's going to be great coming off of a foot injury, especially if they try and rush him back, right?
I have sang the praises of Frank Reich more than anybody on this show. Okay. I love him. I think he's an unbelievable coach. I think this football team is built exactly the way you're supposed to build a football team. The way I would build it, okay? The farther away from the ball you get, the less value I put in that because I think you can find guys there. I think they have some young receivers that I like a lot. I like Michael Pittman a whole lot. Oh, God, they have got one other young guy that I love. His name just went out of my brain.
And then they still got T.Y. too.
I'm not worried about T.Y. T.Y.'s toast, baby. T.Y.'s. He's probably got experience, and he's probably can make a couple of big, meaningful catches. He cannot separate anymore. This is what happens. Father Time catches up to you, and receivers fall off a cliff after they turn 30 and they start having injury problems. I think so little of Carson Wentz. I don't know that Frank Wright's that magical.
Are you talking about, let's see, I'm pulling up the wide receivers right now. Zach Pascal, Paris Campbell. Come on.
Paris Campbell. That's it. Yeah. Paris Campbell and Michael Pittman. Those two guys are young. Those two guys are I think are good. I think they're good. I think they're a quarterback away from being a hell of a football team. Carson Wentz, I got this team 6-11. I don't think they're good. I don't think Carson Wentz is good. I don't think they're getting close to 9. You're gonna see something here. This division is last year's NFC East. Mark my words, we're gonna struggle to find a team to get to 10 wins.
You no trust in the Titans here.
No, sir.
Okay. No, all right. Sir. We'll talk
you
about
still, that. You still got to play both sides of the ball. We'll get there.
That is true.
This is a team that I love. This is a team. This Colts team, if they had a quarterback, I don't need him to be a great quarterback, okay? All right. I just need him to not be Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz has been horrible.
Here is people. Let me ride through the beginning of their schedule just to give everybody an idea. Sure. Start off at home against Seattle. Then you've got the Rams coming in. Yep. Then you've got at Tennessee, at Miami, at Baltimore.
I think they'll lose all those games.
All 5.
I think there's a world where they come out of that. Not just a world. I would probably put a lot of money on them coming out of that 1-4.
Yeah, I could buy that. I bet they might be able to find a win.
I bet they come out of that. I would bet more that they come out of that 1-4 than they come out of that, I don't know, 3-2.
Oh, yes. Or 2-3.
I don't Oh, yeah, even 2-3. I just don't see them doing that. I don't think this is a good football team. And here's the thing. I think this is a great football team. But I think quarterback is that important. I don't think Frank Wright can hide his flaws. I think he had a magical 3 months his sophomore year. And everybody is hanging on to those 3 months. Before then, his entire life. After that, his entire life. We've never seen him look close to that. Why do we think those 3 months is what he really is? And every other week, month, day in his life, he's never looked anything like that. Why do we think those 3 months is what he is?
So along with that schedule, after that five-game slate, they've got Houston. Should get a win there. And then you go to San Francisco, and then you've got Tennessee on Halloween. You get the Jets and the Jags, but then you got to go to Buffalo. You play Tampa Bay. And then you've got New England on the back half of the schedule, the Raiders, you know, the Cardinals, et cetera. So
like I said, I didn't say they get 0 wins. I got them at 6.
Yeah, you got them at 6.
I think they're going to fight like hell in that Seattle game. I think when they have to play Arizona, I think that game's going to be a scrappy, tough game. Like, I don't think outside of when they have to play the Houston Texans, and let's see what the Jags look like this year, I don't think they got a good win, an easy win in the books all year.
No, I tend to agree.
I think every win they have are going to be hard-fought, close, one-score game wins. And if the ball bounces the wrong way, they don't get any of those. So you better beat the Jags and you better beat the Texans.
Yes, 100%. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.